Good morning, everyone, or good evening, everyone. This is Keith Bearden, and I'll be your announcer today, along with Mrs. Lively from Buchanan.
Hi, I'm Elisa Lively from Buchanan, West Virginia, on the host committee for WAMSBY 2023.
And I'm the announcer for WAMSBY, Keith Bearden, Texas Tech University, a WAMSBY judge and on the WAMSBY board, but I'll be announcing today. We have a great lineup in the parade in this beautiful little community of Buchanan, West Virginia. It's a town of about 5,000 to 6,000, is that correct?
Correct.
And the community has turned out, they're lining the streets. It was a festive party last night after the field competitions, and we look forward to a great day of parade. The beautiful weather that is with us, we're very fortunate, it's not very hot. So we have several bands today, many floats. We have the mayor, we have bagpipes, we have Queens, we have Miss West Virginia. So many different things in the parade today. So you're going to be seeing lots and lots of fun things. We're a few minutes away from the first group actually arriving here at the grandstand. But I think you're in for a treat. And thank you for tuning in all over the world. We'll go silent for just a little bit until we come back. Okay, we're live here at the Buchanan, West Virginia Street Parade featuring bands from the WAMSBY, a World Association of Marching Show Bands. The police have passed. Here comes the American flag, and everyone is standing as they should for the presentation of the colors. our judges today for the street parade. Mr. Chris Herard from Canada, Mr. Hans-Dieter Buschau from Germany, Jim Ford from Nova Scotia, Canada, John Helmick from USA, Mr. Paul Duke from the Netherlands, and Mr. Brian Engelson from the USA. The West Virginia State Police have passed, as well as the Upshur County Sheriff's Department, the City of Buchanan Police Department, all who have provided such great security for these events this week. The Wamsby banner has passed. The Diablada Boliviana is now coming by. Very colorful uniforms, some local cultural music. From Bolivia. Very colorful uniforms. Miss Lively, what do you think?
I think they're amazing. They've actually visited us during the Strawberry Festival, which happens every May in Buchanan. And they're a true favorite of all the fans along the parade route.
I can't imagine all those uniforms, making them and coordinating them. And that's a pretty good pace they're carrying. I hope they can make that the whole parade. Very lovely. So next coming up, we have the Division I banner sponsored by Dutch Miller, which is now passing by. We appreciate the sponsorship of Dutch Miller. Dutch Miller is an auto company here in Buchanan, West Virginia. And they've given generously to support the festival this week. So many businesses have stepped up to provide support. Now we have some Indy 500 cars passing by. This one's sponsored, but it says the Willard Battery Special. What a sweet car, number 98. Here comes another one, number 22.
And the cars are being driven by Shriners. And the Shriners locally do so much for our community and for children with medical needs.
Yeah, Shriners is a fraternal order. They sponsor hospitals for burns clinics throughout the country. The Shriners are a wonderful organization. They have an Indy Club Car, Indy 500 Club Car Association here.
They're always a favorite in all of the parades that happen locally, and they do so much for our community.
Wonderful group of men and women. Thank you. Coming up, we have the mayor of Buchanan, Mr. Robbie Skinner. And he's on the... No, not yet. I'm ahead of time. I'm sorry. This is the Dutch Miller float. Dutch Miller float. Beautiful. That took some work. Has an IndyCar 500, a big star, American flags, flowers, the American flag. Dutch Miller Auto. We have a little pause here until the next band, the first band passes. It will be the Chopin Les Amoureux from Switzerland. So we'll pause until they arrive. Thank you. And I see our first band coming in the Walmsby Street Parade competition this morning, all the way from Switzerland. The show band Les Omarines, under the direction of Mr. Andrew Lechte. They have been a crowd favorite this week in concert band, in field show, and field parade, and now street parade. Their uniforms are very, very beautiful and very unique.
Can I say, these groups have been staying at West Virginia Wesleyan College, and they have been a delight. It's been like a melting pot on our campus, and this group has been a crowd favorite.
They're very precise in everything they do. It's not our normal band that we expect. It's a fife band, all flute, piccolo, percussion, but their uniforms are simply stunning. All piccolo and flute. Absolutely beautiful, stunning uniforms. Great youngsters, great young adults. We have the Glockenspiel. From Neuchâtel, Switzerland. I was looking through their uniform. They have the daggers on their belt and a music pouch, probably a raincoat. If I know the Swiss, they're well prepared. Maybe a Swiss Army knife in there.
We have the mayor of Buchanan, Robbie Skinner, along with the mayor of Elkins, a neighboring city, Mayor Marco. I can't say enough about the city of Buchanan and their support for the World Association of Marching Show Bands. We've been preparing for 2 years when we put in the bid, and so Buchanan has just stepped up to the plate. So that's Mayor Marco and Mayor Skinner.
And they are walking, they're not riding in a vehicle. That says a lot about those two gentlemen. Thank you very much. They have a backup car unless they get tired, I guess. See if they, in case they get tired.
Probably carrying some water.
Yes, carrying water. It's not a hot day, but it's a humid day. But the bands are doing really well. And next we have the Buchanan Upshur High School Band. Upshur County. The city of Buchanan and their marching band is coming up the street. They should be playing momentarily. They're not entered in the Walmsby Street Parade competition. They're just performing. We appreciate them being here. Schools do not, some of you have asked why more USA schools are not involved. Our schools are not in session during the summer, so all the students are on break. So it's very difficult to get a band together in the summer for any competition events. Most bands will pull together a community band for a parade. Students are here in the summer and they volunteer their time.
I have to brag a little bit. The band director, who is brand new, is Tyler Persky, along with Taylor High, who are both West Virginia Wesleyan alumni.
And that's really difficult, being a new director, coming in and asking students to come play in a parade when they're on their summer vacation. So we really appreciate his efforts. Great looking uniforms, beautiful hats and plumes, red, white, and blue. See the sousaphone covers, B&U. Playing Johnny B. Good. Great job by the BU High School Band, the host band for the Walmsby events this week. They have given so much of their time and efforts, plus performing shows and doing their part to help make this a wonderful event. Next is a unique drill team. They're on Segways. Can you tell us about this group, Mrs. Lively?
I can. They're from the Villages in Florida. A couple of representatives came several months ago to visit Buchanan and decided they wanted to bring their group here, and they all ride on Segways, and they just had a tremendous time visiting West Virginia. So enjoy them.
And the Villages is a retirement community.
It is.
Yeah, and they're riding Segways. That's good. That helps keep your balance. I'd be afraid I'd fall off backwards. They even have Uncle Sam. It says the Segway Riders Club of the Villages in Florida. I know the Villages has many golf courses. This is unique. Enjoy them. They're all carrying American flags. They have their Segways decorated up with the red, white, and blue banners. Red hats, they're styling today. And there are so many of them.
There are a lot of them that have traveled to West Virginia, and what a unique group. This is a first for Buchanan, for sure. They've not visited the Strawberry Festival or anything, so first time in Buchanan.
Those must be really strong batteries to last a two and a half mile parade. They're doing great. I'm sure they all have golf carts to get around the Villages back home. Those are really unique people carriers.
Now the next group coming up is the Highlanders from Elkins, West Virginia. Mayor Marco, you saw just a few minutes ago. The Highlanders is a bagpipe group that are a favorite of every parade in North Central West Virginia. They're based out of Davis and Elkins College, and I would like to say that Davis and Elkins has been hosting one of our bands in their residence hall as well.
And how far is Elkins from Buchanan?
It's about 25 miles.
About 25 miles away, and they come to support their neighboring community. Love a bagpipe band. Here they are carrying the American flag with the kilt. Great tradition of wearing the kilts. No, they wore the kilts in Scotland. I was always concerned about playing golf in a kilt because of the mosquitoes.
Now this float represents the West Virginia Wildlife Center, which is located just outside of Buchanan, about 12 miles in French Creek. They are a wonderful organization where you can go and see all animals native to West Virginia.
Wow, and I see pictures of mountain lions, great horned owl, elk, a weasel, bear, turtles, I mean all kinds of wildlife. And the young ladies have bubble machines, and we're getting a blessing of bubbles here on this beautiful day in West Virginia.
Some of the groups that are visiting with us have been fortunate enough to go out and visit the West Virginia Wildlife Center and see all the animals.
That's a treat. Next we have the showband.ch from Switzerland. Now people say, what is showband.ch? Well, in the USA we have .com, and in Switzerland it's .ch. So they thought that was a unique name to go showband.ch. Very clever. And they've been a big hit. They place very high in all the events they have entered. And as a matter of fact, they will be in the finals tonight of the show band competition this evening out at Ross Field.
And if you haven't gotten your tickets, you still have the opportunity to come see us live in person at 7 p.m. tonight at Ross Field.
7 p.m. There'll be 10 bands, only 10 bands, doing their field performance. It's going to be lots of fun.
This is an amazing group. They have just added so much flavor to the campus of West Virginia Westland. We enjoyed hosting it.
They have very unique uniforms. Oh, what a feeling. We're in the USA. We're used to having high school bands and all the students are here within 3 years. Across the world, the bands are not necessarily in high school. Some are, but most are community bands. They range in age from 8 years old to 60 years old. You never know what you might see in the real parade. You see adults with little kids. So this is a unique band. Beautiful uniform. Very good band. We're so happy that they have come all the way to West Virginia from Switzerland. This next boat is called Balloon Small. And both Mrs. Lively and myself were wondering what this is about. We're going to find out in a moment. It looks like a purple something, horned frog coming out of a teapot.
Well, it's definitely a crowd favorite for the little children watching the parade.
Well, I guess it's like on the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade where they have tethers, so it's probably filled with helium, and they walk down the street carrying this little balloon. The wires are pretty low here, so they couldn't do that. So they put it on a float and anchored it down, which is very clever. Coming up next is the Calgary Stampede Show Band from Canada under the direction of John Meacham.
Now this group is definitely a crowd favorite, and this show band won the Battle of the Drumlines.
They did. Thank you for reminding me. The Battle of the Drumlines was won by the Calgary Stampede, and they will be in the 10 finalists for tonight's big show at Ross Park. If you haven't gotten your tickets, want to get out there and see that. Here's the Canadian flag. We have the rifle team, the drill ladies. What a dedicated bunch of youngsters. All these bands have to work all day and perform and work up their shows. They give lots of hours of time and dedication to their craft. The Stampede Band is a very developed band. They have a rich history of winning. Their red boots have been a crowd favorite of everyone. They have great looking uniforms, and the drum line wears red boots, as do the drum majors. Calgary Stampede Rodeo happens every summer. This is the feature band, and they do all the work around the rodeo. If you've never had a chance to go to Calgary, go to the Calgary Stampede Rodeo. It is amazing, fantastic event.
They've definitely been a crowd favorite on campus at Wesleyan and in the Buchanan community. I would strongly encourage you to come watch tonight for the top 10 band to perform at the finals of the field competition. And if you can't make it to Buchanan, definitely watch live stream.
And here's the guy that makes it all happen. Wamsby, president of the organization committee, Mr. Randy Sanders. This gentleman is the Energizer Bunny incarnate. He works tirelessly to make everything happen, that make sure all the I's are dotted, all the T's are crossed. Untold hours and energy spent. I can't imagine the amount of phone calls, emails, and texts this man has received over the past 2 years. Thank you, Randy Sanders, for all you do for your city. You're a proud citizen of Buchanan, and they're proud of you.
We definitely are. Randy has led a team of people on the host committee and lots of volunteers to make this week happen. So shout out to Randy Sanders.
How many people are on the host committee?
Oh, there's only five people on the host committee.
Five on the committee. And how many volunteers do we have this week?
Hundreds.
And that takes a great coordination effort from the committee to organize. Very fine group from Ohio. For the judges. There was a little lull in the parade and they had time to stop. There's no one behind them, so that's okay. Normally we like to keep the bands moving, so not to hold up the parade, but there was a good gap behind them and they performed magnificently. Thank you, Robes Hollow Regiment Drum and Bugle Corps from Northeast Ohio, which is a neighboring state to West Virginia.
Were they just playing The Price is Right?
I don't know what
that was. The Price is Right. So The Price is Right. We're so glad they made it to Buchanan.
We have a stilt walker. We don't have his name or where he's from, but that has to be a challenge to walk on stilts and juggle. The question is, what if he drops one? That'd be a long way down to pick it up.
I'm pretty sure one of the crowd favorites would pick it up for him.
There we go. He doesn't have a follower, but someone will jump out of their chair with no risk of it being taken, because this is amazing. Last night, all the chairs were lined up along the parade route in Buchanan. People put their chairs out and they come back the next day and it's still there. Marvelous testament to the community. Nobody takes a chair, nobody sits in someone else's chair. That is an incredible thing going on in this little community. And actually that happens in all the small towns across America. Small town America is the pulse and the heartbeat of the United States, where you can put a chair out for the parade and have it be there the next morning with no one sitting in it.
You know what? It's cliche, but that's what small town charm's all about.
Here we go. We have next the... We had President James Moore. No? Didn't come today. This is the Calgary Stetson Show Band, and they are from Canada. They are the direction of Jeff Waterbury. A magnificent group. They will also be in the top 10 tonight for the Show Band Championships. You notice we have several bands from Calgary, the Roundup, the Stetson, and the Stampede. It's a feeder system. They start out in the Roundup band, then graduate to the Stetson band, then they go to the Stampede. It's a great system for building a great group. The Stetson band is really fantastic. Calgary Stetson Showband from Canada, our neighbors to the north. You see the water wagon following them. That's very important in a parade when you're wearing uniforms that are very hot sometimes, and you're doing a little uphill for 2.5 miles. It's nice to have cold water if a student overheats or anything. So we thank those people. There's so many people that aren't in the parade that make this go. The security, the parade route workers, the people who are distributing water and popsicles and all kinds of things. Like last night, they were walking up and down the streets distributing free water and free popsicles. What a great treat for the town of Buchanan.
That was courtesy of a local business owner who owns a business called Pops Furniture. So he is a tremendous asset to Buchanan.
So many people have gotten behind this. Here comes a Division II banner, Walmsley banner, and it is sponsored by the West Virginia University of Medicine at St. Joseph, or St. Joseph.
Yes, that's our local hospital. They have been a huge support to Walmsley, as well as lots of efforts in the community. We cannot thank St. Joe's Hospital. They took the time to research every country. They made a book about every country so that when they were coming, their native language, anything that they would, if they had someone come to the hospital, they were prepared. So
that is great.
A better partner.
And I saw the other day when the bands were out, it was so hot, there were two ambulances that came to the campus, and they were taking care of those students or those band members. And so we really thank the West Virginia University of Medicine, St. Joseph, for taking care of everyone. Just like the police, the fire department, security, the volunteers, the hospital is also behind it. In a small community, everybody gets into the effort. It's so wonderful to see that.
And now coming, we have Bethel Marching Band. They have been a huge crowd favorite on campus and with all the other bands. And I might add that it's been a huge delight to watch all the bands just support everybody. There's no animosity. They are just supportive. They're not like they're battling. They're just there for everybody and cheering everybody on.
Yes. Now, the Bethel Marching Band is from Honduras, and they're directed by brother and sister Eduardo and Wendy Gomez. How neat is that? Carrying the beautiful flag of Honduras. We've had Switzerland, Canada. Now we have Honduras. We had a band from Ohio, USA. This band has been a crowd favorite, bringing their culture and their heritage of Central America. Bethel Marching Band from Honduras. Bright, beautiful uniform. Bright blue, white, black, with beautiful blue plumes.
Miss West Virginia USA, Nevaeh Harmon. She is a student at Marshall University on the student government, and she is visiting with us, recently crowned on the campus of West Virginia Wesleyan, actually. So that's Nevaeh Harmon.
Beautiful car, the beautiful young lady, Miss Nevaeh Harmon. Miss West Virginia Teen USA. No, Miss West Virginia USA. Teen will be coming up. Oh, I hear a band. There was a crowd pleaser last night down on Main Street. Main Street was open last night till around midnight, and people were partying. They were having a great time. Some of the bands came down and played. This is a band from Philadelphia. They're called the Whoa Fat Band. And it's trombones, a tuba that can take the place of 50 tubas, and a drum, a little drum section, bass, snare, cymbals, I think. So they were very entertaining last night. The Whoa Fat Band, it's a little jazz group. I can't imagine how much fun these guys have when they get together to practice and when they go out and perform. They had throngs of people gathered around them last night. They even teamed up with the band from Hong Kong, and the kids from Hong Kong started sitting in with them and improvising. It was a big party.
When I asked them last night for a description to talk about them on the live stream today, I said, I looked you up on the internet. All I found was one statement: a badass brass band from Philly.
A badass brass band from Philly. And you can hear the trombone. This is fun. They have fun. So we have a bass drum, a snare, and a cymbal player, a sousaphone. And seven mighty trombones. Oh, they're gonna play for us. Get ready. Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. They were a hit.
You can tell they have a lot of fun.
Oh, they do. And last night was so neat because they had the little band from Hong Kong teaming up with them. Now we have the Miss West Virginia Teen USA.
Yes, this is Lakin Campbell from Parkersburg, West Virginia. She was recently crowned at the same time Nevaeh was on the campus of West Virginia Wesleyan, a part of the Miss USA pageant.
Coming up the street now is the Ängelholm Marching Band from Sweden. Ängelholm Band is directed by Christian Schupli. They will also be in the finals top 10 tonight in the show band championships. Let's listen to Ängelholm. They're playing the crowd favorite, Country Roads, West Virginia, by famous the late John Denver. Needless to say, this is a crowd favorite. Okay, Great Ängelholm Band from Sweden. Next we have the Elks Lodge Float. The Elks Lodge has been a very supportive sponsor this week, the Elks BPOE Lodge here in Buchanan, West Virginia.
Yes, the Elks have been very supportive of the WAMSBY, and we're appreciative of all they do for the local community and support. They give out scholarships. They're just a very great organization here in Buchanan.
Another great little community organization that supports community. Buchanan doesn't have the Statue of Liberty or the skyscrapers of the big cities, but they have a common bond of humanity, working together for each other, helping each other.
Now the next band coming up is from Taiwan. I will say they've been staying at our neighbors in Elkins, at Davis and Elkins College, and we want to give a shout out to them for hosting Shen Kuo. But I want to tell you, their director over there told me one night they practiced till 2 a.m. So they mean business.
Shen Kuo High School from Taiwan, they're very serious about what they do, a very good band. They'll be in the top 10 tonight. Their director is Yichuan Lin. Thank you. the Chin Kuo High School Band from Taiwan. They are so such perfectionists. They rehearse. They're very clean. They're very dedicated. Thanks to the sponsors and parents who have come along in their delegation to help. Next, we have the Lions Club float.
Yes, the Lions Club is a huge part of Buchanan and Upshur County. They are very philanthropic, but one of the main things they do is make sure they give the gift of eyesight to folks. They take recycled glasses and make sure that local people get their needs met. But can't say enough about the Lions Club and what they do for our community.
Another fraternal organization here in the community of Buchanan, existing solely to help people, the Lions Club. Next, coming up the street is Spielmannzug Hochstadt from Germany. The Hochstadt band had travel issues, only arriving night before last at 2 a.m. and they got here in time to perform last night. They did both their field parade and their field show. And their field show was good enough to get in the top 10 for tonight, this evening's performance at Ross Field at 7 p.m. This is a different group. They have, again, piccolos. As many of the groups in Europe, they will have just a fife and drum, or maybe just bugle and drum, or maybe just a drum corps. But this is a very entertaining group. They're very precise in what they do. Here they come. The Spielmannzug Hochstadt band from Germany. They're under the direction of Melanie Falter. Coming up the street is the West Virginia Strawberry Festival float. Mrs. Lively, tell us about the Strawberry Festival.
Well, the Strawberry Festival is one of the largest festivals in West Virginia. It happens every year in May, but let me step back. We have some representatives before that from the Forest Festival, neighboring in Elkins, West Virginia, and the Queen of the Fort, Queen Maid Sylvia, is from Buchanan. And so that's our neighboring. Caroline Fluke is the maid, and they that's a huge festival that happens in October. And for the Strawberry Festival, it happens every May in Buchanan. One of the largest in the state of West Virginia. And here we have the royalty riding on the parade. And Kenny, I'm a past president of the Strawberry Festival. It's an amazing group of people that put on a huge festival week long with many things that you've seen while you've been here that happens during the Strawberry Festival. Street parties, carnivals, and things like that. So shout out to the volunteers on the Strawberry Festival board.
I can't imagine how neat that would be. So do you grow lots of strawberries in this region?
We do. Unfortunately, May is not the best time for strawberries, but we do have growers. The king is chosen as a strawberry grower. The queen is chosen in a pageant. So it's quite unique.
Interesting. Everybody loves strawberries. Coming up the street now is the Calgary Roundup Band. The Calgary Roundup Band is under the direction of Heidi Harbrick from Canada. You'll see younger members in this group. And they're sporting their Calgary white hat. Following them is the Mountaineer Challenge Academy South. This looks like it could be an academy or a challenge for maybe teaching survival or camping skills, outdoor skills and activities. Thanks.
Actually, the Mountaineer Challenge Academy is a school for youth who have had troubles and challenges in their life, and it's located in Randolph County, and they have been a tremendous asset to our community, and it's a great school for these folks to get their lives back in line.
Wonderful. And we have to help those that get off track. We have to help those who come back to society and be fulfilling members of society. This is a great organization that does that. They take troubled youngsters, teenagers who have taken the wrong path, and they bring them back to focus on things more important in life. Thanks for the Mountaineer Challenge Academy South. Coming up the street is the Cortegas Latin Band. The Cortegas Latin Band from Honduras. And they're under the direction of Wilmer Matamoros.
I will say they've been staying at our neighboring Alderson Brothers University. So I want to give a shout out to the folks over there for hosting Cortegas.
That's the neat thing about a little community. All the surrounding towns and colleges jump in to support where they can offer. We have three bands from Honduras, Central America, and they get here to the World Championships if they qualify in their region events. So these are the best bands in those events. And so if they score to win those events, they're invited to this. I'm sorry, I gave you the wrong number. They're out of order here. This is the Malasori Band. The Malasori marching band from El Salvador, Daniel Medrano. Our list was inaccurate. This is the Malasori band. Certainly, every time they perform, we appreciate their efforts in coming to West Virginia from El Salvador.
State Senator Carnes, who is a great supporter of West Virginia, riding in our parade today.
Coming up the street is the Twistman Band. The Twistman Winds, actually they're called. They're from Hong Kong, and their director is Kel Mann. Last night in the evening on Main Street, the Twistman were performing downtown, and the Wofat Band was around the corner. They joined up, and they were having such time. The students from the Twistman were dancing and clapping, and eventually some of them joined the Wofat Band, and they were jamming together and playing songs that they all knew.
And I tell you, they were the first band to arrive last Thursday, so they have won the hearts of Buchanan. They've been to a couple's home for a barbecue. They went to another couple's farm to see all the farm animals. They have just won the hearts of Buchanan. They did three concerts downtown. They're a fan favorite. I know they're going to be back.
And here they come.
Thank you.
from Hong Kong, the Twistman Winds. They're wearing their traditional uniform.
Strawberry Festival Board of Directors. They don't often get the chance to just be in the parade because they're always behind the scenes during their festivities. That week they have three parades, so shout out to the people on the Strawberry Festival Board.
We know how supportive families have to be if one of the members of the family is working as a volunteer or a teacher or a director or a worker at anything. The supportive family means a lot, so it's nice that they're honored with the float. And they get to enjoy the parade in style by being a part of it on a float. That's the best way to do a parade, is ride by. As a band director, I always wonder why the people didn't just pass by and the band stand there. I think the order has changed back now. Maybe Cortegas Latin Band is coming up the street. We'll confirm that in just a moment. The order doesn't always go as planned because you have sometimes transportation problems, traffic problems, parking problems, you name it. So the Strawberry Festival Committee is so flexible and very innovative in getting things fixed immediately and very supportive to make things run on time. For all the community members who have turned out today on this beautiful day. It's a little cool breeze. It's overcast with some clouds, so the sun is not burning down on the audience. We appreciate the weather being on our side. Okay, it is Cortegas Latin Band from Honduras, and they're directed by Wilmer Matamoros. Looks like their sponsor donated a truck. Very nice. Exciting Latin music. They're still away from the judges' stand, but you can hear them coming up the street. Very colorful band. Traditional costuming. The young ladies in their beautiful skirts, headdress, floral hair pieces, it looks like. Cortegas from Honduras. Young ladies up front in their beautiful Latino pink dresses, the ruffles, the flowers, absolutely gorgeous. And they get the street rocking with the Latino beat from Honduras. Thank you. carrying the beautiful Honduras flag. Here they come, for Ortegas. Crowd pleaser for the Ortegas marching band from Honduras. Coming up the street, they're about a block away. We'll talk about the East Fairmont High School Band. They're from neighboring town Fairmont, West Virginia, and they have gotten a band together for this summer voluntarily, and they're coming over to support their neighboring community.
Yes, Fairmont is about 45 minutes away. The East Fairmont Busy Bees participated in the opening ceremony. So, and they were kind enough to come back and participate in the parade today.
I recognize the band, and Alan Heath, their director, has been very helpful in the press box for the field shows over at Ross Park. He's been our communicator to the field reps, when to send the bands, when to start the bands. He's been our technological helper up there. We really appreciate the director of this East Fairmont High School Band from nearby Fairmont, West Virginia, Alan Heath. Thank you for all your efforts.
This particular band has been fortunate enough to appear at the Pittsburgh Steelers halftimes for several years in a row and been to lots of parades in D.C. and Orlando. They're just outstanding in the way they represent West Virginia.
Very generous of the students to give their time to support their neighbor communities. I'm Mr. Coach of the Director's name. This is Director T.J. Bean. Director of the band is T.J. Bean at East Fairmont High School. Beautiful uniform, drill team. Wow, look at the plumes on the drum major and the band. Beautiful blue. And that could be their fierce mascot if you're ever stung by a honeybee. Again, thank you, East Fairmont High School. Director Mr. Bean, for bringing your wonderful group, supporting your neighboring community, Buchanan.
Now we have some cartoon characters from a local business called Cartoon Headquarters that provides a lot of entertainment. Bounce houses, we use them. Actually, we had a party for all the bands on campus on Tuesday night, and we used this company, and they had a lot of great fun with the band members participating for the evening, and they just provide lots of entertainment for North Central West Virginia for parties and events.
All the WAMSB events provide entertainment for all the members of the bands to get together. It's a great social time for them to get together and meet one another. And music is a universal language, so bands come together as friends. They're not enemies. They're not like football teams who want to go out and kill each other. It's really a great unique friendship among bands who are supportive of each other. They clap and cheer. It was so neat last night to see the band from Switzerland supporting the band from Honduras. They were in the street just dancing and clapping and following them along the road, staying with them as support the whole way. Okay, coming up the street is Buenos Verdes Marching Band. The Buenos Verdes Marching Band is from El Salvador. Their director is Renzo Fuentes. Putting the El Salvadorian flag. One of the very good and entertaining group. Okay. Okay, the next group coming up the street is the Elkins High School Band. Mrs. Lively, tell us about these guys.
In neighboring Elkins, the director is Seth Blake, another West Virginia Wesleyan alumni. We have a great fine arts program at West Virginia Wesleyan that produces lots of great students. But Elkins, neighboring, again, their Davis and Elkins College is hosting one of the bands over there, and we just have a great partnership. Their mayor was in our parade earlier, and let's take a listen.
The Marching Tigers is one of the oldest programs in West Virginia. They play for the football games, many parades in the area, plus traveling to Florida. They march in Veterans Day Parade, Christmas Parade, and the Forest Festival Parade, just to list a few. The Elkins High School Band from neighboring Elkins, West Virginia. Here they come. High School Band passing by there, not in the Wamsby competition, but again a local area band here. The Division III banner, sponsored by Mike and Ike.
Division III is sponsored by Mike Ross and Ike Morris, local oil and gas company owners in this area. Ike is from neighboring Glenville, West Virginia. Mike is from Colton, neighboring Buchanan, near Elkins. They are huge supporters with their company called We Are Farmers.
We Are Farmers. Another community support network member. If you've never been to West Virginia, I highly encourage you to come. It is a beautiful state. I've never seen so many green trees and rolling hills and mountains. It is beautiful. Lakes, rivers, and streams, great golf, great tradition, great history in the great state of West Virginia. The South Shore Drill Team is coming up the street. Their director is Arthur Robinson. This young group of 50 plus has been a favorite in Buckhannon for several years, beginning in 1980, with four neighborhood youth as a traditional military-style color guard. Arthur set a standard for the group, but they always had a flair for performing. So this is what you see today. They have traveled all over the United States. The South Shore Drill Team from Chicago, Illinois.
I will also add that they put on two performances for the bands on campus on Friday evening before the street party, and they had them packed out in the Performing Arts Center for two complete shows, and they are amazing.
So we've had a group here from Philadelphia, now we have one from Chicago. They've got some rocking music. It's great to see youth involved in such a great activity in South Chicago. We need more of these groups in our large cities to keep youth focused on their lives. This is great. Great drill team with rifles. Great looking uniforms. They are good. In their beautiful green and gold uniforms. All right, very catchy. We have the rifles, now we have the color guard. The South Shore drill team from Chicago, Illinois. We thank them for coming down and participating in the Wamsby Festival and community events here in Buchanan, West Virginia. Okay, coming up the street now is the Banda Filharmonia. The Banda Filharmonia is from Honduras. Their director is Jackson Burke. They have been a great hit in the street parade today, coming along the route, and they've been in a concert band. They've been in the field shows. Entertaining group from another group from Honduras, Central America. Beautiful flag of the country of Honduras. They're from Culateca, Honduras. Lovely ladies with the batons and their beautiful costumes, their blue boots and very ornate dresses. Thank you. you, the Banda Filarmonia from Honduras. Following them is the Cartoon Headquarters Float from Harrison County, West Virginia. As we said earlier, with the other float, they had a party the other night for all the band members. They had a great time having a party. This is the great group to call. They have all the bounce houses and characters you can need. Looks like we have some Mario Brothers on this float. The Cartoon Headquarters here in Buchanan, West Virginia. Party time. Coming up the street is a very special band because of the travel issues they had, and I'll explain that. This is the Wood and Brass Band from Poland. Their director is Czesław Simeon. They arrived, but their luggage and their instruments did not arrive. They finally got their luggage on the second day. The community pitched in to support, giving them items they needed. Surrounding communities donated instruments so they had instruments to play. I don't know that their instruments have arrived yet. Some of them did, okay. So the surrounding communities gave them instruments to play in the concert band competition and the earlier competition. So that was a real travel issue they had. But the Wood and Brass Band all the way from Poland, and here's their beautiful red and white flag. And their director, Czesław Simeon. They're from Gdynia, Poland. A little John Denver, Country Roads. Right behind the Wood and Brass Band, we have the Lincoln County Cloggers from Hamlin, West Virginia. Tasha Smith is the director of this group, and they travel to the Cherry Blossom Festival in Washington, D.C. They give lessons for anyone wanting to learn how to clog. The Irish dancing is clogging. This dance is an Appalachian dance passed down through the years by each generation. Probably came from Ireland. The clogging, you reckon?
I guess. Imagine.
Great group.
Marching through the parade? How about clogging through the parade?
Yeah. Through the parade? I'd be worried about slipping on those taps on their shoes. But they look great. They did a wonderful job, and we thank them for supporting their neighboring community. Next, coming up the street is the Crumlin Community Band from Crumlin, Ireland. Their director is Roisin O'Neill. The beautiful Irish flag, the green, white, and gold, along with the United States of America flag. The Crumlin Community Youth Band. Dublin, Ireland. Perhaps it's Crumlin, my mistake. Crumlin Community Band, Northern Ireland. Excuse me. Dublin, Ireland. I'll get it right in a moment. Thank you. Thanks to the Kremlin Community Band from Ireland for participating in the Wamsby events this week.
This is just coming up now, a local company called Misbehavin', who does balloon art, and you can see how unique it is. They were just recently in the Strawberry Festival Parade. They're from nearby Weston, West Virginia. Very unique balloon design, don't you think?
That's amazing what they could do with balloons. It looks like a big dragon there. I guess the name of their company is Paint Misbehavin'. That's pretty clever. They have several groups here. I think there are two. We see a dragon. I'm not sure what else is coming up. It's like the Rose Parade. All of those floats have flowers or natural ingredients. This is all balloons, different shapes and sizes and colors.
It's interesting. They put the design together for the Strawberry Festival on campus, and they have to blow up each balloon, each balloon that you see three different times to climatize it so it comes out of air conditioning to survive in the heat.
Wow, I did not know that. Yeah, because I guess if it's in the heat, it deflates.
Right.
Or cold, maybe. Cold would deflate. Heat would inflate. Very clever. The balloon art.
And we'll have to give a shout out because they use the Buchanan, West Virginia Wamsby colors in their design.
Absolutely. I didn't notice that. Thank you for pointing that out, Mrs. Lively. Beautiful. Yes, they've got all the colors, West Virginia, Wesleyan, and Wamsby. Very clever. We have a bubble machine lightening the festivities of the day with bubbles. Who doesn't like bubbles? Unless they get in your eye. Paint Misbehavin'. Clever name. Very unique. I've never seen a group like this. There's a trumpet, there's a saxophone, musical notes. They have everything. Thank you, Paint Misbehavin'. Next, we have a group from Ghana, the National Cadet Corps of Ghana. They could not bring their band because of some travel issues and challenges, but some of them came to march in the parade. That is so, so incredible. All the way from Ghana, West Africa. So they're doing sort of a drill thing. Who would have ever thought Buchanan, West Virginia, would have groups from Ghana, Ireland, Honduras, El Salvador, Canada, Sweden, Switzerland, Germany, Hong Kong, Taiwan. It's amazing. All descending on this community of how many? What's the population?
About 5,000 to 6,000.
5,000 to 6,000 people, and all these international individuals from different countries have descended on Buchanan. The Shango Mountain Taiko Float is next from Berkeley Springs, West Virginia, bringing in the heartbeat of Japanese taiko drumming to the mountains of Appalachia. Performed at the Morgan Arts Council, Sakura Matsuri, Japanese Spring Festival, and then at Bringing in the May Fairy Festival, taking new trainees all the time. The taiko drums.
Did you see them at the street party last night?
I missed them.
Yeah, they were awesome. And we're gonna hear them now, I hope.
Taiko drumming is very popular, of course, in Japan. I see we have some very innovative taiko drums up front with some plastic trash cans. Next, we have some more shrine units from Upshur County Shrine. Usually they have motorcycle clubs, go-kart clubs. We saw earlier here are the motorcycles. Again, the Shriners support burn hospitals all across the country for those who have been severely burned. And the money they donate through their fundraisers is just enormous. What a great support that they do for the people who are having burns. Children's Shrine Hospital. Wow, they do so much. Members of the community giving back through the Shriners.
And this is the local Shriners Club from Upshur County in Buchanan here.
Local folks, helping other local folks. Not only in the community, but the state. I didn't realize we had a group from Guatemala here, and I see that they're coming up next. It says the Clarinet Four from Guatemala. Another Central American country. I'm gonna have to count up how many countries are here. I didn't have Guatemala on my list earlier. The economic impact that is created from bringing all these people from other countries into this community have been wonderful. The restaurants, the ice cream parlors, which is my favorite. I don't have other information on the Clarinet Four from Guatemala. I hear something other than clarinet, so. Oh, this is the Green Beret marching band. We changed orders. Okay, the Green Beret marching band is from Wisconsin, USA. And they've been participating in all of our events. Wamsby Street Parade Competition. Beautiful green berets. The Middletown Tractor Sales. A big front end loader. Looks like it could be a hay baler. I'm not sure what they have here. The John Deere Company supplies equipment for any farming need you have. They have several locations around the state. Looks like they've donated $32,199 to charity events. Middletown Tractor Sales, John Deere. There's a neat little tractor.
And in the side-by-side, we have the people who put the parade down the streets today. So shout out to our parade crew. And followed up by the State Police of West Virginia. And we appreciate it. It's been a great parade.
Fantastic, and it went a lot quicker than I thought. It's only 1:49. That was an hour and 45 minutes for all those groups over a 2.5 mile route down the beautiful streets of the community of West Virginia. Thank you so much worldwide for tuning in to our telecast. We hope you've enjoyed the program. We hope you've enjoyed the Wamsby bands. In addition to that, all the community help and support from the local floats and townspeople in surrounding areas from Philadelphia, Chicago, everywhere. It's a group effort. It's a party in Buchanan, West Virginia. See you tonight, 7 p.m.
Yeah, 7 p.m. on behalf of the host committee. Thank you for tuning in and join us tonight.
Thank you very much. Signing off, Wamsby World. Bye-bye.